Well, Anne Arundel County State Delegate Republican Don Dwyer potentially faces some serious legal charges tonight, and experts say his political future is in doubt. 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins has been following the developments, and David joins us now from the newsroom with more. Dave.
Stan, in the words of one legal expert, Delegate Don Dwyer is in a world of trouble. Potential charges carry a jail sentence. And legal issues aside, if convicted, a bill he voted for could toss him out of office.
Really in no condition to give a press conference right now.
Political and legal experts believe Delegate Don Dwyer's attempt to get out in front of his drunken boat collision does him more harm than good.
It's inappropriate for him to, it's dead wrong. I understand what he's doing. He's seeking repentance. There is a time and there is a place. Children were hurt. There's no excuse. But we have to know, he has to know all the facts before he starts apologizing and saying I had a .20, because he's painting himself into a corner, which he may never be able to get out from.
Attorney Bruce Robinson believes Dwyer faces several charges.
The biggest charge he has is operating under the influence, operating a vessel or a boat under the influence. It carries a maximum of a year. And then there's a reckless charge that can be associated with that, which carries another 30 days on top of that.
Dwyer and his boat passenger, John Moran, a political candidate in 2010 and current police officer at the University of Maryland Baltimore campus, collided with another motorboat on the Magathy River Wednesday. Dwyer, other adults, and several children ended up in the hospital. According to sources, investigators are checking the bar tab Dwyer and Moran ran up at this Eastern Shore establishment prior to the crash. UMBC officials say they see no reason to discipline Officer Moran. Dwyer declared his alcohol level was more than twice the legal limit. Experts contend the amount of alcohol in his system, the accident, and the fact children were hurt will be unforgivable to a judge.
You have the public trust. You violated that trust in a major way, and now, you know, I'm going to punish you for that.
Legal consequences aside, Dwyer could lose his seat. A bill Dwyer voted in favor of, which will be on the November ballot, immediately removes a lawmaker after a criminal guilty verdict. Current law allows them to stay in office until sentencing. The statute also applies to conduct contrary to community standards.
I think drunkenness is regarded as a case of moral turpitude, and that this would apply to him.
Dwyer's own party is distancing itself. The GOP caucus explained, "While we appreciate Delegate Dwyer's frankness, we are troubled by these circumstances." Like Dwyer, experts say the GOP misfired.
Make a point of condemning what he did, but praise his honesty and try to identify your own party with that kind of moral behavior.
Natural Resources Police are aware of Dwyer's comments about drinking alcohol prior to the accident, but investigators are not taking action just yet. They're waiting for results of the blood tests they gave him, which may not be available for weeks. Coming up new at 6, some sobering numbers regarding intoxicated voters. Reporting live from the newsroom, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.